Good morning and welcome to today's worship at the Salvation Army Isle of Wight Corps. For our opening song this morning, we're going to sing song number 855 from the songbook, I Will Sing the Wondrous Story.
Thank you.
We have a number of people to pray about in our core at the moment. We've got a number who have COVID at the moment, Rodney and Lillian. We know that Pauline and Clive have been poorly. We also know that Louise has been unwell. And we know that Nikki has been unwell too. I'm sure there are people that I've missed out, but let's hold them in our prayers today. Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to pray this morning. We pray, Lord, that those who are poorly and not with us at the hall this morning will recover soon. We pray for all those who are struggling with coronavirus. We pray for all those who are struggling with other ailments and can't be with us. Lord, we pray that your Spirit will be with them today and all the time. Lord, we pray for the situation in Ukraine, that things will improve. We pray, Lord, that you will give wisdom to those that can make the decisions, and that those that are on the front line helping the refugees coming out of Ukraine will be blessed by your presence and able to save as many people as possible. And Lord, we pray for ourselves in the hope that we can spread your good news, that we can tell the world that you really are a loving, fantastic, magnificent God. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. We are going to have a piece from Edinburgh Gorgie Songsters called I've Been Changed.
Wipe all the tears from my eyes, and I'll
Our next song is number 197 in the Salvation. Are you weary? Are you heavy laden? Burdened with sorrow, weighed down with care. And then the chorus now goes, I know a fount washed away. I know a place where night is blind eyes made to see. There's a wonder working power in the blood of Calvary. We'll sing this song together, and then there'll be a short tribute to General John Larson, who was promoted.
Our lives can be filled with questions, from the weather to where we might go today. Our questions will guide us significantly depending upon where we go for the answers. The author of song number 171 in the Salvation Army Songbook writes this song with that device in mind. As if just having read Jesus' words recorded in Matthew 11:28, Oliver Mark Cook asks these questions. Say, are you weary? Are you heavy laden? In verse 1. Are you still doubting power to keep from sinning? Verse 2. Fettered and bound by chains of self-indulgence, verse 3. He answers with the bold fourth verse, wondrous deliverer, sin-forgiving saviour, cleanser of hearts, unfailing friend and guide, no one has ever trusted unavailing, no one has claimed of his love and been denied. And completes his solution with the chorus, I know a fount where sins are washed away, I know a place where night is turned to day. Burdens are lifted, blind eyes made to see. There's a wonder-working power in the blood of Calvary. Read and feel the confidence of the writer who is fully dependent upon God and our Saviour Jesus. This can and should be your own testimony today.
Are you in bondage to Today is the day when we shall gladly be saying to the Lord, I give my heart. Lord, I'll do my part. Here are my 5 loaves. Here are my 2 fishes. Whatever you want me to do in the local community, wherever you want me to go, Lord, you can trust me. Sometimes we're perhaps uncertain what it is precisely what God wants us to do, but he will show us. We have those words, I give my heart, I'll do my part. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. And we say, I give my heart, I'll do my part.
Our Bible reading this morning is from Luke's Gospel, chapter 4, from verses 14 to 21. Now Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news about him spread through the whole countryside. He was teaching in their synagogues, and everyone praised him. He went to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and on the Sabbath day he went into the synagogue, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him. Unrolling it, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." Then he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendants, and sat down. The eyes of everyone in the synagogue were fastened onto him, and he began by saying to them, "Today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." May the Lord add his blessing to that reading. We're now going to sing a real old-fashioned song. It's number 884 in the songbook, and it's Climbing Up the Golden Stair.
Thank you.
I invite you to join me in a little prayer. Heavenly Father, may the words of my mouth and the thoughts of all our minds be acceptable to you, Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Now, about 7 years ago, the then territorial commander, Commissioner Clive Adams, launched TIDE, which stood for Transformation, Integration, Discipleship and Effectiveness. I wonder how many of you remember that. Well, last year, the Salvation Army launched a new mission statement based on the five marks of mission, which have been developed by the Anglican Consultative Council since 1984. So I wonder if anyone's heard of these five marks. They are, the first one, to proclaim the good news of the kingdom. Number two is to teach, baptize and nurture new believers. Number three is to respond to human need by loving service. Number four is to seek to transform unjust structures of society, to challenge violence of every kind and to pursue peace and reconciliation. And number five is to strive to safeguard the integrity of creation and sustain and renew the life of the earth. So these have been reworded and reordered a little to provide the Army's new mission statement, which says to share the good news, to serve others without discrimination, to nurture disciples of Jesus, to care for creation, and to seek justice and reconciliation. So how do we tie the territory's mission to our local mission on the Isle of Wight? Now, that's not a question to be answered in a message today. It's something that needs to come from prayer, thinking, discussion, and practice. However, over the next few meetings that I have the privilege of leading, over whatever period that is, I want to look at each mark of mission in turn from a scriptural and spiritual perspective and start the thinking process. So today I want to look at that first part of the Army's mission, to share the good news. We'll look at share. So what on earth is the Salvation Army for? What are we doing here this morning when we could have rolled over and enjoyed another hour in bed? Now, with the number of COVID cases locally at the moment, it's as good a time as any to be asking these questions. The pandemic has rearranged our experience of church and core in all sorts of ways. We hear the phrase, the new normal. And there's widespread agreement that as life opens up again after the pandemic, although I think we're still pretty much in it at the moment, that things will look different. For us, patterns of work, leisure, education, even family life are likely to be different from before. And let's add to that the pattern of the core. As society changes around us, we in the Army need to adapt so that we live and speak the good news of God's saving love in ways which make sense to people. Now, at this point, I want to say a bit about what I mean when I say the word mission. Now, maybe you think mission is a funny kind of word. Some people find that it has off-putting associations. Perhaps it has association with you with Christian ministry, overseas work. Perhaps the word mission makes you think of large evangelistic rallies. Now, if the word has difficulties for you, just park them for a moment. Mission begins not with what we do, but with who God is in Christ, God who is Father, Son, and Spirit. Now, God is Spirit, says the Apostle Paul. In the Bible, God, the Holy Spirit, is a restless energy. In the power of the Spirit, Jesus is sent out into the desert. And in the power of the Spirit, he is sent into Galilee to proclaim the good news. When the Spirit comes upon the disciples at Pentecost, they leave the confines of the upper room and are sent out to tell the world of Christ crucified and risen. The Spirit is typically moving outwards, expanding the circle of God's saving love and sending others to do the same. Now, the Latin word I send, for I send, is missio. And that's where we get the word mission from. And while we're doing ancient languages, the New Testament Greek word for I send is apostolo, which is where we get apostle from. So the mission of God is to be turned outward in saving love towards the world. The mission of the church is simply to share in that, to get caught up in that. Now, one classic definition of mission is to find out what God is already doing and to join in. I love that definition. And the way that it reminds us that grace is at the heart of faith. When we talk about mission, it feels like we're rolling up our sleeves to get busy. We constantly need reminding that God does not need us to save the world. He's already got that bit sorted. We are not saviour. We are those who have received grace upon grace. So to recap, a missional church is a church that is sent outwards in the power of God's Holy Spirit to share God's saving love in word and action. In other words, to do what Jesus did in his earthly ministry. The call to mission is not a new thing. Okay. So the first mark of mission, as it's written in the Salvation Army's mission statement, to share the good news. This is a natural starting point because it comes from Jesus's own summary of his mission to the world. Part of the reading we heard earlier from Luke 4, in verse 18, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free. Jesus went around Galilee telling people that the kingdom of God has come close and that they should repent and believe the good news, telling it, living it. Then he sends out the disciples to do the same, and in Luke's gospel, a further wider group of 72. Jesus built a community around him who are tasked with doing as he does. And right at the end of the gospel, the final commission from the risen Jesus is that we should continue to build the community by making disciples of all nations. The call to proclaim the good news means that we are to communicate the saving love and hope that is in Jesus. And there's an important point that I'd like you to take note of today. The call for the Salvation Army to tell the news is not a call for officers alone. It's for the whole Salvation Army. It's what the army is called to do. Every soldier, adherent, attendee, volunteer, junior. An officer's role is to proclaim the good news, of course it is, but just as importantly, to enable and equip us to do it. I wonder what you think about that. Do you find that daunting, surprising, energizing? Now let's think about the word afresh. We proclaim the good news and we proclaim it freshly. The way we communicate our faith needs to be refreshed so that it is heard in a fresh way and meets the need of this generation, a generation that is different to the last generation. Now, Anglican Bishop Steve Croft apparently holds the record for writing the best-selling church report of all time. Now, since publication in 2004, his report, Mission-Shaped Church, has sold tens of thousands of copies. The report said that Britain is no longer a Christian country. It is a post-Christian country. Because of that, we're in a situation we need to adapt. And the report goes on to suggest ways that that can happen and has ideas for setting up new congregations and creating fresh expressions of church to connect with those for whom traditional church is simply not on their map. Now, does that mean that traditional forms of church have had their day? I don't think so at all. Now, we have some traditional core, and they've done really well. And at the same time, we innovate. We start fresh expressions of church. We develop new congregations. And I hope this both and is an approach that we can take in our core. Now, on the Isle of Wight core, we have our traditional Sunday morning meetings and the online YouTube broadcast, which you're watching at the moment. The Sunday evening prayer meetings are both live and on Messenger. And yes, we could do more, like reviving open air ministries or explore other innovative ways of telling the good news to the Isle of Wight. Now, in Matthew's Gospel, Jesus tells a parable about disciples being like the owner of a house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old. And I think that's a helpful way of approaching this. Now, in the music cupboard, we have a mixture of new music and stuff that was written 60 or 70 years ago. There are some treasures there that tell the same good news regardless of age. Now, the old methods of worship in the army, such as holiness and salvation meetings, have been replaced in many core with a single worship meeting. Now, do we do that because it's more effective or because it's easier or more convenient? I'm not aiming to start a debate on whether or not it was better in the old days, but I am going to end with this question. How do we share the good news in a world that has changed significantly since many of us became part of the Salvation Army? Let us pray together. Life-giving God, send us out in the power of your Spirit to proclaim the good news, to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
God's Spirit is in my heart. He has called me and set me apart. This is what I have to do, what I have to do. Don't worry what you have to say.
Our final song this morning, 37 from the songbook, We Are Witnesses for Jesus. Hope you've enjoyed this morning's meeting. I hope you stay safe and blessed during the course of the week.
Song of experience this time, telling of our response to Christ as his witnesses. We are witnesses for Jesus.